Taal volcano still showing signs of a possible hazardous eruption. The Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology, or PHIVOLC, says although the intensity of activity in Taal's main crater has slightly eased, the eruption is still ongoing. The agency has recorded hundreds of volcanic earthquakes since Sunday. New vents have also opened up.
Tuloy-tuloy na paglindol na malalaki, kasama ng fissuring, no, yung mga panibagong fissures, ay naghuhudyat po na mayroon talagang magma na umaakit pa sa Taal. No?
PHIVOLC warns residents not to return to their homes yet amid risks posed by the restive volcano.
Again, nire-reiterate po natin, hindi po porque humina ng kaunti ang surface activity sa main crater, ay ibig sabihin ay naibsan po ang panganiba na. Lalo na po ngayon na meron na tayong fissuring.
So far, the National Economic and Development Authority has pegged the impact of the Taal eruption on Batangas's economy alone at 7.6 billion pesos or over $150 million. If Taal's unrest drags on, an economist warns, it could pose a temporary speed bump for the country's growth. That's as he notes, Calabarzon, the region where Taal is located, is an industrial and car assembly hub just a couple hours' drive from the capital. It accounted for 17% of the total Philippine economy in 2018. That's the second largest share of the national economy, behind only the National Capital Region. It has been the second largest contributor to the Philippine economy since at least 2009.
Calabarzon contributes quite a chunk of economic activity, so any derailment in its, progress could be a drag on economic activity going forward. However, I think this should give ample space for BSP to continue at its accommodative stance, just to give the economy an added push.
The country's Tourism Infrastructure and Enterprise Zone Authority, or TIEZA, meanwhile sees Taal's volcanic activity as an opportunity for local government units to study the impact on tourism that calamities could bring. It adds, the entire Calabarzon region has a great potential to become one of the Philippines' prime tourist destinations.
After this, we'd look at the master plan and see the effects of what happened just recently, and then see where we can do the promotions moving forward. What kind of industry, what kind of utilities, what kind of infrastructure would be required moving forward.
TIEZA is an attached agency of the Tourism Department. It had earlier turned over completed infrastructure to the local government units in Calabarzon and is now looking at where they can come in to help in the rebuilding process of affected areas. Dino Ponte-Urig, ABS-CBN News.